Hello friends, in this video we will see the key important environmental current affairs for 2021 prelims. So what I have done is that I have basically used the monthly current affairs and the yearly current affairs of important institutes, and I have taken the most probable questions or most probable topics necessary for your preliminary examination, and I have made a video. So, but the point is that you have to understand that these materials which are being given are very tough. I do not know why they dump so much of information into them. The reason for example, chess players, you can ask the chess players, if they are playing these chess games, very well-versed chess players, if you ask them and they are playing the chess game, and in between the chess game, the pieces actually shatter. Let us assume the pieces shatter. The chess players can align the pieces. These are grandmasters I am talking about. The chess players can align these pieces because this alignment has a context. This alignment has a meaning. Okay, so they will remember all these things very well. That is how your brain works. Your brain works when you actually collate all these information and make a collage out of it through the context and observe the pattern. And the problem with these current affairs is that they have dumped everything, many things. They actually are in isolated pockets. When they are in isolated pockets, it's not easy to remember. But if you happen to see, if you apply that logic of these chess players and understand the context, understand the meaning, understand the logic why they are there in this current affairs, and progress for this preliminary examination, it will be very easy. And that is what I have tried to do in this video. This will be a series of videos. I cannot make everything. I do not want to dump everything in the same video. I would want to make it in a series of videos, and it is actually easier for me as well. So I cannot also make a very long video and edit it and put it over. So it will be a series of videos, and I can assure you that it will be helpful in relation to environmental current affairs for prelims. So let us go into the video. So the most probable prelims topics from environment current affairs is what we will see in this video, and I have taken the monthly current affairs and the yearly current affairs of important institutes, and I have made a collection of important topics which I feel might come in preliminary examination 2021. So I have ordered that in that way, and my name is Sivaraja Rajendran, and with that information we will go into the video. And I feel this is going to come. Let us see if it is coming on October 10th. Let us see. But I feel this question might come because, first is this international panel or intergovernmental panel on climate change. So the year, first you have to know the year. It was created in 1988. The second point is by who? So first point should be the year, second point with the World Meteorological Organization and the United Nations Environment Program. This United Nations Environment Program, what it means is that it actually functions or it coordinates the environmental programs of United Nations. This is very, very key. And the third point you should know is that this IPCC, this Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, it works at all levels with science. See, in the sense that government has to be given this scientific information of climate change. So who does that internationally is that IPCC. And see this, they have all the nearly 195 members. So all the members are there. And fifth is this scientist. So how does this international or this panel of climate change advises government is that they have a band of scientists who volunteer. See, they volunteer and there are paid people also. But you know what was the question they asked? This question already UPSC has asked. That is why I feel that this question, I think it was asked in 2015 or 2016. Somewhere around that this question was asked when the Paris Agreement was signed. I have that in the next slide. I will tell you the reason why. See, that is what I said. There is a context for everything. What we do is that we usually read everything in an isolated fashion. Not everything is isolated. Nothing is actually isolated. Everything has a connection. And they asked this in, I think, 2015 they asked. You know what question they asked? They said that IPCC, this was the statement UPSC gave, IPCC conducts its own research. What they said means they conduct their, they are releasing these climate change data. They said that they are releasing that by own research. This statement, whether it is true or not, if you remove this statement, actually the answer will come. But see this line, what does this line say? IPCC does not. They do not conduct research on their own. What they do is that they collect information, and these volunteer scientists, you know, these volunteer scientists actually look at all these data, and they actually, what they do, then they give this report, and that is how this report is formed. But in this case, you have to know why I have kept this, that every six to seven years, the assessment report or the climate change assessment report by IPCC is released. The fifth one, so why the fifth one was released somewhere around 2014 to 15. So the fifth assessment report, see, this is every year. So every year, in a cycle of 6 to 7 years, this report is released. But the fifth assessment report was released in 2014-15. Why I said this, remember this? I said the question was asked, remember, 2015 somewhere. See this? So after 7 years, they have released this, they have released this sixth report. See, now it has come. So this is the assessment report they have made. Now this report has come a few months back. That is why I have included this first thing. Please look at it. Please look at the key things which we have said. And the sixth report, you don't have to go in very deep. Just to browse through what the sixth report says is that urbanization and the floods. This may be a mains question. You think about 2011. So we'll go there. 2021, mains question, IPCC report based urban floods. Actually, in that report, it is saying that urban floods will increase because of climate extremities. Urban floods are going to be increased, but this will be a mains question. Okay, but preliminary question somewhere, this things which we discussed, please look into this. And why I said, see, that is what I said, the context, fifth report, please check that. Okay, and see, I have made this United Nations Environmental Program. So what this, World Meteorological Organization, United Nations Environment Program only created this. They can give this also. They can say some other organization. They can say United Nations, or they can say some other organization. Let us assume many other organization they can say. And they will tell that it was created by, IPCC was created by that. But no, it was created by WMO and UNEP. Please look at that. What is this UNEP? So next thing, see, that is the context you have to know. The first, you know, I will tell you a very, very nice, interesting anecdote also. The UN Conference on Human Environment, which took place in 1972. So this was the first, first thing ever. That is why I have in my notes, I have kept it as the first. This was the first environmental conference. And you know what? This important thing is that actually Indira Gandhi, who was the prime minister at that time, she attended that conference. This was the conference in June. And you look at when she came back, from that conference, very important key environmental law, which is called as the Wildlife Protection Act. Do you understand why they keep asking this Wildlife Protection Act? And you know the year 1972, This was passed after she came from this conference, and this Wildlife Protection Act is the most important act in preliminary examination. It has so many features. I have explained it in the important topic section, for example, why it is important and all. So if you see this act, why this has a connection, this is not something which was formed without any, that is what I said, not in an isolated fashion. This is a thing, there is a connection. So United Nations Environmental Program, so in this conference it was decided to have this United Nations Environmental Program, and you know what, this United Nations Environmental Program coordinates many of the environmental features. And what are all the environmental conventions it coordinates? Mean it coordinates everything. So in this, they will give this. So what this, why this is important is that they will give you a table. So in preliminary examination, they will give a table and they will ask you to match. So in this match, if you see what is Vienna Convention, you have to know. This is about a chlorofluorocarbon. Remember this ozone layer. See, the first is this ozone layer depletion. Vienna Convention is about ozone layer depletion. Next, you have to go and see what is ozone layer depletion, how it happens. So that is what, that is a very deep environmental concept. So all this environment class, go check why ozone depletion is happening, where it is happening, what are the reasons, factors, which is, now actually I read an article yesterday saying that ozone layer or ozone layer hole is very maximum right now in the winter. Please check this, why, so what is the reason, what hole, where it is, everything, causes. But Vienna Convention, ozone, okay. Then this Basel Convention, what is Basel Convention, you have to know. Persistent organic pollutants or hazardous, see, hazardous material. So there was a convention for hazardous material movement, you know. So that you have to know. Next is this Earth Summit. Earth Summit is where United Nations Environmental Framework Environmental Framework Convention on Climate Change. So this was formed. See this? This was formed. And this Global Environmental Facility. This was asked in UPSC. Please check this, what this is. See, this Global Environmental Facility is a thing where they fund, okay, for funding Global Environmental Facility. We think there will be an environmental, it is a facility or a platform, but it is a funding platform. Global Environmental Facility is a funding platform. This you have to know. And this United Nations Desertification, CBD or sites, or this Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species, I have in separate slide. So we will discuss that there. So UNEP, please check that, and this, all these convention and what these conventions are, very, very important. Please check it. Okay, so this is the thing. See, that is what I said. The most important things in UPSC is in the Wikipedia. Open source. UPSC is one of the, see, that is what I say. UPSC is an open source platform. It is like, it does not actually restrict itself. So if you see this Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, it was formed in 1988. Headquarters is in Switzerland. So see, the parent organization, they have given this, see, World Meteorological Organization, everything. And see this IPCC's fifth report, and heavily informed. You check that thing where I said that it helps you, IPCC helps in making assessment for the government. So it was helpful in the Paris Agreement. Now you understand why UPSC asked this question in 2015. Now why I say is that, see, the sixth assessment cycle has been completed. To be completed, actually they have released the report. Okay, they have released the report few months ago. That is why I have kept this. I am stretching my neck outside, and I'm feeling that this question might come. Please look at it. Okay. And see, why I, there is a context for this, why I said that, means, see this, government has constituted an high level ministerial committee. See, the Paris Agreement was signed. Paris Agreement, the environmental report for Paris Agreement was heavily given by IPCC. It was started in this 2016. I have Paris Agreement in the subsequent videos, but I am saying, so what, the government of India now has constituted high level ministerial committee. See, why? Because they have to implement the Paris Agreement. See, what is the Paris Agreement means? We have nationally determined contribution. That is, we are saying that we will reduce these greenhouse gas or this climate change causing things we will reduce. So what are all the nationally determined contribution is very important for mains. But prelims, I am, maybe we'll read that for prelims as well. So we will check that as well in the next slide. But I'm saying this ministerial committee will look into this. But why I'm saying is that this year, see this year 2021. So what year is this? This year is the beginning of the implementation of the Paris Agreement. See, that is why I think that this will also come, or this might also come. See, that is what I, probable questions. It's not, I'm not a predictor. It's a probable question. Okay, because I feel that it is a year of implementing Paris Agreement. IPCC report has been released in the 7-year cycle. So it is a 7-year cycle. So it has been released. So they will implement, or they will give this question. And what is, see, that is what? What is Paris Agreement means? It is a legally binding. See, they will say that it is not legally binding. See, this is the word they will give. But it is a legally binding international treaty on 196 conference. So see, this COP21 Paris, it was given us, see, this 12th December 2015, this was formed. And you can check the question paper, you can check the question paper of 2016, you can check the question paper of 2016. Paris Agreement was asked December 2015, this climate change convention happens. 2016 prelims paper, this question is asked. So the climate change conventions, everything is important. That is why I am keeping. Now is the year of implementing. So first thing you have to know, it is legally binding. Second thing you have to know, they want to limit it below 1-2, but it's okay. Even if it is 1.5 also, they are trying for that. So our aim is to go to 2. See, limited, or the global warming temperature, we want to limit it below 2, but 1.5, okay. Check that. And this is the change. Third point is that, see, all brings all nations in common cause. In the earlier, so Kyoto Protocol and all, there was a distinction of developed and developing. So there was a distinction. But in this conference, that was the change which happened. Everyone was actually brought into the same framework, saying that no longer, because India and China had argued for the sake that they were a developing country. They had poverty in a large fashion, and hence they cannot bring down or cut down their greenhouse gas emissions right now, because poverty happens to be the most important thing to tackle. But in this conference, it was actually not taken into, or they took into consideration, but they wanted every nation to contribute. So this all nations. And then there is a 5-year cycle. So it is starting from 2020. Okay, it is starting from 2020, and 2021 is the implementation year. So prelims question will come. Okay, so prelims question will come maybe next prelims question 2025. Okay, this is how maybe it will come. So this is the agreement. So what are all the agreement? So fast we will go. Okay, see, fast we have to go. What is the agreement means? The goal of limiting global temperature. So they want to limit it in below 2.2 degree. But their efforts now is 1.5 degree. See, the UPSC will ask 3 degree. Okay, their global temperature they want to bring down by 3 degree, 4 degree. See this, it is in the band of 1.5 to 2. And then see, they want to, they will give this climate neutrality. What they want is that they want peaking of greenhouse gas emissions very soon. So I think it is 2025 or something, or 2030. Please check that when they are in the IPCC report, actually it is given. In the IPCC report, they have said which year the peaking of global greenhouse gas emissions should be there. From that, it has to reduce. That is the thing they are saying. And then mitigation. See, binding commitments. See, this is binding commitments. Please check this word, binding commitments. On all parties, this is the word, this is the key word, binding commitment on all parties where they give, you know, where they give, but they are not giving directions. See, it's a binding commitment on all parties, but they are not giving directions. You have to reduce this much, you have to know. They are giving you the leverage nationally. That is your, you have to decide, your nation has to decide. So that is what intended nationally determined contribution. Intended nationally determined contribution was asked in mains as well. But see this, so we reduce that. Next page I have this. So again, so this is the important, and they have to, you see, they have to improve the sink, carbon sink and reservoirs for greenhouse gas emissions, and there have to be a market. So market, possibly a voluntary cooperation, and the adaptation is very important, and the loss and damage, if there is any loss and damage due to climate change, you can actually have this convention helps you to recover that. So this, these are all the key factors. Finance, this every, see, all these are in every, see, this is a document. All these things are present in everything. This will be helpful for mains maybe. So there should be a financial, see, this Green Climate Fund, who, please check this, who or under whose capability this Green Climate Fund is there. Global, there is a, see, here we saw Global Environmental Facility. Okay, UPSC will ask these two. What is Global Environmental Facility? What is Green Climate Fund? See, these two things now you have to check now. So, please check these two. What is this? What is this? This is an important question they might ask. Please check this. And then there is an enhanced agreement and transparency is there. Okay. So what we have to, and this global stock, so they will, maybe they, this word feels fancy, maybe they will have this global stock take. That is, every year they have to see how the global emissions have been. So this global stock take, all these are in the agreement of Paris Agreement. Okay, but what you have to know is basically legally binding within 2 degrees centigrade, and it's bringing all nations, including developing nations, and it's nationally determined contribution. It's a voluntary nationally, see, it's not a binding contribution, or it is not for per se. They are not, they will not direct you to reduce this much. It's a binding commitment of all parties, where the nations have to give the contribution, where they say that they will reduce this much. And what India is saying is the, see, India is saying is the next, basic, it was adopted in 2015 in the Paris or United Nations. So in the December conference, UNFCCC conference, actually, if you see, the UNFCCC conference always happens in December month. December of every year it happens. So in this conference, this was decided. This was decided that this Paris climate change or Paris agreement would be formed. But United States, if you see, who have not ratified, means United States, actually Trump, when Trump was president, he withdrew from this agreement. But now after Joe Biden, they have rejoined it. So this is a thing they keep doing. But anyways, we need to focus on the important things only. So this is the point. What contrast? This is the contrast I said. The 1997 Kyoto Protocol, the distinction will be there. See, what is a developing nation? Developed nation, this was the fight which was happening in this climate change conferences. But in this Paris conference, it actually reduced. Okay, this is our target. See, what we have done is that, see, this is India's intended nationally determined contribution. What we have said is that first emission intensity of its GDP, see this, it will be reduced by 33 to 35% by 2030. See, this is the point, by 2030 from the level of 2005. First point you should know, emission intensity. See, it's emission intensity, it's not total emission. See, this word UPSC will give, they will say total emission reduction. No, emission intensity is different. Okay, emission intensity is different because it is related to GDP. That is how much emission by GDP. Okay, or the opposite. So please check that formula. See, the another thing, see, I am making all these videos in a very fast manner. So if I am some details I might actually not say at say it perfectly. So your job is to check, but emission intensity is related to GDP per GDP. Okay, not total emission, my friends. Please check that, because UPSC will say total emission reduction by 33. No, it's emission intensity. Second point. See, carbon sink of the sink, that is, they will reduce this 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide by additional forest. So additional forest, this third, see, Global Solar Alliance. What is this Global Solar Alliance? This was also asked. 2016, this was also asked. So many, that is what I am saying. I have actually made it in a way that the context is very important. So three things very important. In these are the intent and nationally determined contribution. Next, what is this solar? See, this is what is this treaty? This is a treaty based on intergovernmental organization to create what? To create a global market system for solar power. See, for solar power, they are creating a global market. And the office of internet, why this question is very important, means the office is in Gurugram, India. Okay, one climate change office, which is in International Solar Alliance office, is in India, Gurugram, and hence this is very forming a very important part. But you know what they said, with the 75 signatories, see, this word is important. What this word means? It's a global collective, right? Global, that is, this is global. It is international, okay, International Solar Alliance. Why I am stressing this fact is that UPSC, you know what they asked? They said that the member countries, so the member countries of this global solar, sorry, International Solar Alliance are people within, see, within this Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. This is what they said. But this is a global thing. See, this is the statement that UPSC gave was, it is a membership is restricted to only countries lying between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, signifying or indicating the fact that only the countries which have high sunlight, because within this sunlight is high, so only those countries are members of this global collective. No, it is not true. It is a international collective, and that is what you have to see, my friends. So, but what are the fourfold? So this is fourfold. What is this global market? It acts as an accelerator, enabler, incubator, and a facilitator. What are all these things? See this. So what is this accelerator means? Buyer's market. See, when only, so what does this do mean? See, what does this international organization does means, only when you create a market, you will have innovation in that, you will have product in that, you will have reduced cost in that. Why solar panels are very costly in the sense that there is no market, so people are not innovating, people are not buying it, so nobody is selling it. So when you create a buyer's market, the cost will lower. So this is the demand creation. So ISA's important task is to, as an accelerator, so demand creation. Next, enabler. See, finding, see, that is the what. So if, for example, many countries are there, they want to change, but they do not have the fund. So they this also acts as an enabler. So it is like giving loan. So or taking loan or helping in getting loan. And then incubator, that is mitigation risk. See, and another thing, solar power projects are not going to give you benefits in the near future. So you have to have some risk, or hedging your risk is very important. And then facilitates consultation, workshop, everything. So facilitator. So talk about this solar convention. So four things. Remember that. Next topic. This is another thing which is very important, I feel, in preliminary examination. I feel that this may also come. See, the Ken Betwa. See, this is Betwa River. Betwa River. This is Ken River. And they want to propose, or they are proposing, a link between these two. See, this is a map question. So they will, the Ken Betwa link has been asked, or one time I think they asked this, but I think no, they have not asked. I think they have asked the link between Krishna and Godavari one time, they asked, I think. So I feel that this Ken Betwa thing, which is now it is in the news, so this is from the news, that is why I picked it. So this might come, but see, they will not ask, see, that is the point, they will not just ask this. When you read a question, the context you have to understand, you have to know the other things concerned with that. See, Ken River, see this Panna National Park, this is very, very important. Panna National Park. So actually what they say is that this link will submerge some of the parts of this Panna National Park. It's a biosphere reserve. It's a tiger reserve also. Please check that. And when you see what is important, when you are reading this, when you are reading this, you should know that this is very, very important. Chambal. So see this Chambal River. Very important. Where it is, why it is running, where it is joining. See, Ken or Betwa is here. Ken is here. Actually, both are, whether both are, see, the question, you know, whether both are joining Ganga, whether both are joining Ganga or Yamuna. You check that in a map, you check it, please. You check these places, whether both these Chambal and Betwa are joining Ganga and Yamuna. This is the question you have to check. And the next point you have to check is, where is Panna? Panna or where is this Panna? This Panna biosphere reserve, tiger reserve, and Panna is actually a gold mining or gold present in the area. And you should also know that there is also next, when you see this, also see this Sanchi, because UNESCO site is that. Sanchi is an UNESCO site. When you are looking at Panna, it is very closed down. Okay, see the map, in map you see where is this Sanchi Stupa? Sanchi Buddhist Stupa, you know? Sanchi Stupa is there. Next, Bimbetka is there. See, Bimbetka and Sanchi in Madhya Pradesh is a UNESCO site. So, when you are seeing Ken Betwa, see Chambal and see whether they are joining Yamuna or Ganga, and see these two UNESCO places as well. So, this will be, so this is how you have to study. Okay. So, thank you for watching this video. And anyone who has not liked it, please do like it, share it, subscribe it, and all the best for your preliminary examination. Thank you.